Sony. It's no secret. I left Sony ecosystem a while ago. I've been raving about the Canon EOS R for some time now. I've been Team Canon. I'm shooting on the Canon EOS R now while holding the Canon EOS R. That's how much I love it. Yes, I bought two. But what Canon is revealing with this Canon EOS R5 is absolutely groundbreaking, and I cannot wait to discuss it with you. Let's get into the video, baby. Canon just absolutely obliterated, wiped the floor clean with all competition at this moment. The Canon EOS R5 is looking to live up to everything we expected and beyond. I cannot believe these specs that Canon just revealed today. I'm gonna share those with you, react to them, and talk about the future of Canon in the camera space and them reclaiming their title as the best. Literally, they will be wiping the floor clean with all competition because this camera right here is in a class of its own. They have created the video creators, photographer, basically our camera. This thing is gonna be packing specs on top of specs on top of specs. Even more specs than the average creator would use. So who is this camera for? What is this camera gonna be capable of doing? And who should buy it? My name is CJ, this is CJ Knows Tech, where I get to know tech so you don't have to. And today we getting to know cameras. Hey Canon player, hey, give Sony a break, man. I don't think they can catch their breath or breathe right now. I used to be hardcore Team Sony. Don't believe me? This right here is the Sony a7 III, and behind me somewhere on that shelf is the Sony a6300, which is where I started my video creating career here on this platform, YouTube. I graduated to the a7 III, and if you ask the majority of any creator, especially a lot of my creative friends, what camera they use, they're gonna say this here, Sony a7 III. Matter of fact, I asked them, you don't believe me? Look.
Because it's the best of both worlds. You get a mean photo camera, it's the low light beast, great autofocus, dual card slots, killer battery life, in-body stabilization, and the list goes on and on and on.
What camera you use, taking me out? What do you shoot with?
I shoot with the Sony a7 III.
Ooh, another a7 III. Yes.
Yo, what's going on?
What camera do you record with?
Right now, it's a Sony a7 III.
Okay, so what camera do you shoot with,
Jackie? I use the Sony a7 III.
That's a popular camera. Why do you use the Sony a7 III?
When Sony came out with the a7 III, and I knew it had a better battery, the 4K on it, I already loved from just the previous Sony camera that I had. And so from that, I just stuck with it, and like the Sony camera just became like a favorite of mine, from the battery, from the color science elements, to the quality of what I was getting, and just overall, it was just kind of that next progression of cameras that I felt like I needed for the channel.
So how is it that me, who used to be Team Sony, hardcore Sony user, has switched to the Canon ecosystem? Real quick, I'm gonna interrupt me for just a brief second. So I just wanna elaborate really quick how and why I switched to Canon from Sony. Now, it's quite the obvious reasons, you guys. A flip out screen, easier menu, just the whole touch screen interaction with the camera. Now, some of you might say, what, you nuts? What are you talking about? Sony gives you so much for so little. They do, but they're handicaps to the Sony ecosystem. How long have we been begging and yelling at Sony to give us a flip out screen, and they still have yet to deliver? I think they're sitting there withholding the A7S III in order to put a flip out screen when Canon is blowing by them with this Canon EOS R5. That's a problem. The color science. You guys, I just wanna slap my footage in and only have to touch it a little bit to get to the final result. This is the ideal work format that I look forward to, and that's the reason why I'm in Canon. There's more to it, I'll do more videos about that. Smash the like button, hit the subscribe button if you wanna hear about that in future videos, and let me know down in the comment section below. Matter of fact, I'm using the Canon right now, the Canon EOS R, and I'm shooting in 4K 10-bit 422 right now with the Atomos Ninja V. I love the Canon EOS R so much, I own two. I'm using the one to shoot right now, and this one right here is my B-cam slash photography slash whatever I don't wanna take that camera off of, that tripod to do camera. The first spec that we're gonna cover is this thing is shooting 8K raw at 30 frames per second. Wait for it, internal. What? This is absolutely nuts. This is like, whoo, this is fire. So will 8K video be the most convenient thing to use? Absolutely not. The files are gonna be humongous, but think about the quality and the crispness. And also, if I take an 8K video, I put it on a 4K timeline, I now have the ability to crop in, pan, and do all kinds of camera movements while not even moving the camera, which gives me a lot of versatility on a 4K timeline. So it's something to think about, something to have. It's nice to have in your back pocket. And if you're trying to compete with the great MKBHD, who shoots everything in 8K RAW, you got a little chance with the EOS R5. Don't compete. Now, here's another thing about that 8K internal recording. It's at 422 10-bit internally. This is nuts. Now, I use the Canon EOS R paired with the Ninja V so that I can get 10-bit 422 external video recording in 4K RAW. I'm being able to be given this in 8K in-body with the Canon EOS R5. This is absolutely exciting, and I cannot wait to test and get my hands on a EOS R5. So what does that mean for me? That's so much less gear for me to have to carry in order to get high-quality 10-bit 422 video recording. I absolutely love the idea of that. Are you guys ready for this one? Here's the kicker, baby. 4K, 119 frames per second, 10-bit, the 422, the works, internal. So slow motion, true slow motion, 4K recording. Whew, man. In C-Log. Did you hear me? So you're able to shoot C-Log 422 10-bit 4K video at 119 frames per second, basically 120. Those of you who love that 120 butter, think about doing that in high resolution 4K 10-bit recording. This is absolutely nuts. This is wiping the floor of any other competitor out there, period. Sony, A7S III? I don't even care anymore. Who cares about the Sony A7S III at this point? This is a power move by Canon to inch, not even inch, to take a huge leap ahead of the competition as the number one spot. Now, this camera obviously has to release and stay proven to the spec sheet without hiccup, and then we can sing the praises of Canon.
Canon, 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 Canon.
Everybody's waiting for the Canon cripple hammer, the Canon handicap, the typical Canon drawback. Guess what? 8K and 4K, no crop! There's absolutely no crop at 8K and 4K recording. Can you say butter? This is nuts, man. This is one of the things that held a lot of creators back from getting the Canon EOS R because of the crop. I'm shooting right now in the 4K crop, but I got a wider lens, so there's ways to compensate for the crop, but the fact that you have to compensate is gone with the Canon EOS R5. Wait, I'm not even done. Dual pixel CMOS autofocus in all 8K and all 4K modes. This basically means you have access to the wonderful Canon dual pixel autofocus. Whether you're shooting 8K this, 8K that, 4K this, 4K that, all of them will come with dual pixel autofocus. There's no handicap in this Canon camera. I have yet to see anything to cripple this camera. And the same goes for Canon Log. C-Log is available in all 8K and 4K recording modes. What more could you ask for? Oh, and I'm not even done. This is a Canon's first. 5-axis in-body image stabilization in the Canon EOS R5. Bravo, Canon. I can hug you and kiss you right now. And the in-body image stabilization will work in conjunction with the optical IS that's found on the majority of Canon lenses, because you never had image stabilization in the body, so it was always in the lens. But having in-body image stabilization work right alongside of the optical image stabilization in most Canon lenses is gonna be a game changer. That means this thing has the potential to be super steady. I'm talking about gimbal steady. I'm talking about GH5 steady. Whew, man. I don't know if I could take any more, but there is more. There are dual card slots, but here's the thing. One of them is a CF Express and the other one is the SD card slot UHS-II. I'm gonna make assumptions that the CF Express has something to do with the 8K internal recording. And just know that CF Express memory is gonna be expensive. This is a different ball game. And the higher up you go in quality and performance and features and cameras, the more you're gonna spend. Overall, the Canon RF ecosystem is not the cheapest, but you get the results, and that's what matters. This quality 10-bit 4K recording image quality that I'm getting, I wouldn't trade for the world. And the fact that I'm going to have the option to go up to 8K and bring it in the 4K timeline and play with it the way that I need to add just more dynamic shots to my videos is an even more of a plus. This is even more of a reason that Canon is going to sweep the creator market by storm. And this is how Canon will reclaim their top spot in the camera market. I don't know what you Sony users are feeling right now. Leave a comment down below. I don't know how you Canon users are feeling right now. Leave a comment down below. And before you do anything else, smash that like button and subscribe. My name is CJ. This is CJ Knows Tech, where I get to know tech so you don't have to, baby. The Canon EOS R5 is coming. It's official. And Sony and Nikon, y'all needs to be worried because it's getting serious. Matter of fact, let me call Canon right now. Hello, Canon. I got a question for you. Look, hey, yo, man, it's your bro. It's CJ Knows Tech, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, the ex-Sony user, now Team Canon. You already know, player. Yeah, y'all remember you guys commented on one of my videos one time. Let me tell you something. The Canon ecosystem has been amazing thus far, and you guys are about to make history with this EOS R5. Don't drop the ball. That's all I gotta say. But the one question everyone needs to know, and the reason why I'm calling you right now, is what is the price? I understand, but we wanna know the price. Okay. So basically, you're not gonna give me the price. Okay. Let's stay tuned, you guys, because this is getting spicy, this is getting exciting, and this is stirring up the camera world. I cannot wait. I'm absolutely thrilled. Hit the like button, hit the sub button. And Sony, SOS, somebody out there, please save Sony, because I don't know what they're gonna do to come back from this one. I'm sorry, Sony, it's over.